You walk into the next patient room and immediately notice a problem. The eye is red. Maybe it looks like this or more like this. And the patient says, "Is this serious?" "I'm Dr. Jasper Trotter. I'm a board certified ophthalmologist. But if I wasn't an eye doctor, this is what I would want to know." And in just 3 minutes, you'll know exactly what to do. A subconjunctival hemorrhage is a common cause of a red eye. It's generally a benign, painless, self-limited hemorrhage under the clear conjunctiva. Think of the hemorrhage as the red frosting in a Halloween cookie, and the top cookie is the clear conjunctiva, and the bottom cookie is the white sclera. It's commonly asymptomatic and often bothers other people more than it bothers the patient. It's commonly flat and can occasionally be bullous if there's a significant bleed or if there's associated edema and a trauma, and this could lead to mild discomfort. Comfort, for which the patient can use over-the-counter lubricating eye drops as needed. But many times, these hemorrhages are an incidental finding. Let's go through the causes of a subconjunctival hemorrhage, and the last one may surprise you. Trauma. And this can be on a small scale, like eye rubbing or a contact lens-related injury, or bigger traumas like blunt or sharp ocular trauma, procedure or surgery on the eye or eyelid. Some examples include cataract, LASIK, or retinal surgery, eye injections, and even eyelid surgery. Valsalva maneuvers like vigorous coughing, sneezing, vomiting, straining, like if someone has constipation, weightlifting, vaginal delivery, and choking. Acute hemorrhagic conjunctivitis, a bleeding disorder, tumor, and interestingly, one of the most common causes is idiopathic, meaning we don't know what caused it. As an overview, in younger patients with a subconjunctival hemorrhage, it's often due to a trauma. In older patients, it's often associated with a vascular disease like hypertension or diabetes. If there's one thing you take away from this video, it's this. In a routine, non-traumatic subconjunctival hemorrhage, other than the actual hemorrhage, the eye exam should otherwise be unremarkable, including the 5 eye vital signs. So in the acute setting, the main goals are, number one, make sure that nothing else is going on. A subconjunctival hemorrhage can be a standalone condition that's going to heal on its own, but it could also be a clue of something else going on, and that's what you want to rule out as best as possible. And number two, get the patient plugged in with an eye doctor, which I'll talk about at the end of this video. If a patient is on a prescription blood thinner, it's recommended that they continue the prescription blood thinner. But any non-prescription blood thinners, consider holding them. Avoid anti-redness or gets the red out eye drops. They're not going to speed up the resolution. If a subconjunctival hemorrhage recurs, it's recommended that the patient follow up with an ophthalmologist and their PCP for further workup to rule out a possible secondary cause like a bleeding disorder or tumor, although this is not common. And for follow-up, in general, I do recommend that every patient with a subconjunctival hemorrhage follow up with an eye doctor. If the subconjunctival hemorrhage is flat, there was no trauma, the patient is asymptomatic, and the eye exam is overall unremarkable, generally that can be an outpatient follow-up. But if there's a 360 or near 360 subconjunctival hemorrhage with chemosis in a trauma, consider imaging, and it's recommended to consult ophthalmology. If you don't have ophthalmology on call, you can consider starting with getting a CT orbits. CT orbits without contrast with thin cuts is really important to assess for a possible globe rupture, and then call the nearest hospital that has ophthalmology coverage and discuss the case and then go from there. So now we're good with subconjunctival hemorrhages, but what is that? And what do you do if you see it in a trauma patient? Check out this video next.